Hi, Kerry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. I have a question from Maya about recording transactions using the two options inclusive of tax and exclusive of tax. So what I'm going to do today is walk through an example of an expense and an invoice using both of the options.
Okay, so let's start with an expense. Here I have a receipt from the Home Depot. We can see here that the total amount before tax was $100.46. And then we have GST and PST, because this is in BC, coming to a total of $112.51. Let's pop this out of the way for a moment. We're going to go here to add an expense. It's from the Home Depot. Haha, added in here. It was paid by credit card. Let's just leave that date. And this was cost of goods sold for our event planning company here in the sample company. So the sales tax, first of all, let's enter this amount, which was 100.46. And we'll tell it it's GST and PST here in BC. And the amount comes to that $112.51, just like we had for our receipt, which of course we could store here. I could attach it here and have it for whenever I needed it. Now, this is when it's exclusive of tax. The other option is we change this to say inclusive of tax. We put the $112.51 here, being the total, the GST, PST, we have to tell it which tax it is, and it calculates it correctly. So if we have another quick look here, we can see that the GST is $5.02 as it's been calculated, and $7.03 is the PST. So if we'd gone ahead and done this from the very beginning, started again, and we'd selected inclusive of tax at the beginning, we would just enter the total and allow it to calculate. So depending on what sort of information you're looking at, maybe it's easier just to enter the total, maybe it's easier to enter the subtotal, but that's the difference between inclusive and exclusive of tax when you're entering in an expense. So now let's do an invoice. So in this situation, let's select a customer. Go with Andre. Oh no, we'll go with Andre. He's in Hong Kong. Here we go. Let's go with Kathy here. And let's say that we've told Kathy that we're going to charge her $1,000 including tax. So let's pop here and we'll go inclusive of tax. And we will sell Kathy a celebration for $500 including tax. And we'll say she's in Nova Scotia. So you can see here that it calculates the HST with the total amount being $500. Now, under normal circumstances, what you would do is you would charge somebody $500 and then you would add the tax to that. And here we would have the amount due would be $575. So it's another different way that you can use the inclusive and exclusive of tax button.
Hopefully that made sense. If not, reach out, let me know if I can help further. If this video was useful, click like below, subscribe to my channel for lots more QuickBooks tips and how-tos. I've created a small business checklist that you can use every month to make sure that your business books are in order and make better decisions. Click the link below and you can download a free copy. If there's anything else that you'd like help with, make a note in the comments below. My next video could be for you. Cheers.